Hello everyone. So here we have to evaluate the limit x tends to 0 e raised to x sin x minus x square upon x cube. So now we'll first of all check that if we substitute x as 0, because here x tends to 0. So what we'll get in the numerator as well as in denominator? So if I'll substitute x as 0 over here, so here we'll get e raised to 0, that is 1, sin 0, which is 0, so sin 0 is 0, so this term will become 0, minus 0, because x is 0, minus 0 square. It means I am getting 0 in the numerator. And if I'll substitute x as 0 in the denominator, we'll get 0 cube, that is 0. So we are getting 0 upon 0 in the term or for the given function. And whenever we get 0 upon 0, then we say it is indeterminate form. So in such cases, we apply L'Hopital's rule, where we find out the derivative of numerator as well as the derivative of denominator, and we try to make it as a finite limit. So let's start with it. So here I'll say, therefore, by L'Hopital's rule, this limit will become L equal to, so now I am applying L'Hopital's rule, in which we'll find out the derivative in numerator as well as in denominator. So this will become limit x tends to 0. Now the derivative of e raised to x sin x, here I'll apply the product rule of derivative. So it will become e raised to x as it is. Derivative of sin x is cos x plus sin x as it is, and derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. So I have applied the product rule for e raised to x sin x. Next, derivative of x is 1, so that will become 1, and negative sign as it is. Again, minus derivative of x square is 2x upon the derivative of x cube is 3x square. Now, we'll again substitute the value of x as 0 and we'll check whether it is indeterminate form or not. So, let's substitute it. So, now x is 0. So, this will become cos 0, that is 1, e raised to 0, that is 1. So, 1 into 1, here we are getting 1. Here, sin 0 is 0, so this term will become 0, minus 1 as it is, and minus 2 into 0, it will become 0. So, we are getting 1 here and minus 1. It means 1 minus 1, we are getting 0 in the numerator. Now, let's take denominator. So, when x is 0, this will become 0. So, denominator is also 0. So, it means still we are getting indeterminate form. So, we will again apply the L'Hopital's rule. And therefore, we will get L equal to limit x tends to 0. So, by L'Hopital's, we will again find out the derivative of numerator as well as of denominator. So, let's find it out for e raised to x cos x. So, this will become by product rule e raised to x as it is. The derivative of cos x is minus of sin x plus cos x as it is, and derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Next, here also we'll apply the product rule. So, this will become plus e raised to x as it is. Derivative of sin x is cos x plus sin x as it is, and derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Next, derivative of minus 1 is 0, and derivative of minus 2x is minus of 2. Upon derivative of 3x square is 6x. Now, if we'll simplify this, then here we'll get cos x e raised to x plus cos x e raised to x as 2 times cos x e raised to x. Next, this plus sin x e raised to x and minus sin x e raised to x will be cancelled, and we'll get minus 2 in the numerator, and in the denominator we will get 6x. So here we got L as limit x tends to 0 into this. Now let's check whether still we are getting indeterminate form or what. So for that I'll substitute x as 0. So by substituting x as 0, here we'll get cos 0, that is 1, e raised to 0, 1. So 2 into 1 is 2, 2 minus 2 we are getting 0. In the denominator, by substituting x as 0, here we'll get 6 into 0, that is 0. So we are still getting indeterminate form, and hence we'll again apply the L'Hopital's rule. So by L'Hopital's rule, here we'll get L as limit x tends to 0. Now here we'll find out the derivative in numerator. So 2 as it is, for cos x e raised to x, I'll apply the product rule of derivative. So cos x as it is, the derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Next, e raised to x as it is, derivative of cos x is minus of sin x. Next, derivative of 2 is 0 upon derivative of 6x is 6. Now, we'll again apply the limit, that is x tends to 0. So here we'll get, by substituting x as 0, cos 0, 1, e raised to 0, 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. Minus sin 0 is 0. So this term will become 0. Here we are getting 1 minus 0. And 1 minus 0 is 1. So 1 into 2 is 2. So we are getting finite number in the numerator. So we are getting 2 by 6. So here I can say that therefore L is equal to 2 upon 6. Or by dividing this we can say therefore L is equal to 1 upon 3. So the value of the given limit is 1 upon 3. Thank you.